What's up, YouTube? It's your Lord and Savior, King D353 here. In our episode of Let's Play, it's technically Let's Waste Time, Animation Throwdown. As you guys can see, the Wrestling Arena Challenge is done, but I figured I should actually have a gameplay episode instead of just another short pack opening episode. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of all of my energy that I've been saving up in both Adventure Mode and Arena Mode, and then we're going to basically do a, We're basically going to do a double pack opening. First, we'll open up the packs that make up... That make up my, coinage, and then we'll go ahead and buy packs... I'm trying to remember what words are, my apologies. Then we'll go ahead and buy some challenge packs. Challenge box packs. Because, although admittedly, now that I think about it, Baseball Bobby would technically be a good card. My end goal isn't to have a single show deck. My end goal is to have a multi-show deck. Which is why I'm not actually going to, Alright, I forgot. Francine's cards suck. Why am I still doing this mission? Yeah, I don't think I want any more Francines. What do I need at the moment? Boop-doop-boop-doop. I have a stand there. How many stands do I need? I do need one more I don't need one more stand, because this needs to get leveled up with energy. More wrestlings will never hurt. More Ruperts wouldn't hurt. More Leelas wouldn't hurt. Wrestlings, Ruperts, and Leelas. I guess I'll focus on wrestlings, why not? Because at the moment, wrestling can be quite useful for me, so we'll just fight the hot tub. That's actually how I decide what level I grind on. I grind based off what card I feel I need the most at that moment in time. And right now, I feel wrestling is the most important card for me to get. Leela's a decent card to have, too. Once I get enough wrestlings, I'll probably start just getting a bunch of Leelas. Because it took me a while to find some good Leela cards, but now that I have found some good Leela combos, I'm very happy with what I have now. Drunk Stan. As you can see, I have two amazing cards here that aren't King of the Hill. Granted, I do have quite a bit of King of the Hill cards in my deck that will probably be staying a while. For example, Hank Hill will be staying until I get the purple, the legendary version of Hank. And yes, there's a legendary version of Hank Hill. I don't know why his card specifically has two versions. I'm just going to assume that every playable character has a legendary version, whether they had an older version or not. And, Bill Dotree is going to be staying until I find other cards that make good motivational or healing cards, because I absolutely love Santa Bill. I mean, I still prefer Bender as a healer, but Santa Bill's motivation is awesome. Plus, I have to double check it, but I think Santa Bill actually heals everybody, which is also pretty awesome. But yeah, maybe if I still had my Boomhauers and Luans, maybe I'd go ahead and get Bobby just to make a King of the Hill deck. But in the long run, I just feel like it's better off to have... Whoa. Hello. In the long run, I feel it's better off to just have some legendary cards rather than Bobby. I could probably do better than Bobby, honestly. I mean, Don't get me wrong, it's a good card, but it's just not my cup of tea. Okay, Klaus, you chill out, bro. You chill the fuck out. Okay, Peter, I need you to punch the fish. You had one job, Peter. You had one job. Ooh, the house actually lived. Wife versus wife, let's go. Crap wife versus crap wife. Seriously, Bob and Hank both have horrible taste in women. I pity them. Also, since I don't know if I'm going to find one, just a random fun fact for you guys. Although you can indeed save ad crates, once you get an ad crate, you can't get any more. Either that or the chances greatly decrease because I haven't got... Because I just noticed I never got ad crates while I had that one held, so... Yeah, you might not want to go holding ad crates willy-nilly. Is all that damage really necessary? Okay, the bulldozer has wall, so I'll trust the bulldozer. I'll trust the bulldozer to get the job done. I was wrong to trust the bulldozer, wasn't I? Mistakes were made. Mistakes were made. Okay. So if I can get one more damage on Louise, I'll be good. Or, better idea. Celebration Stan. Just so I can make this guy even more powerful. Ooh, they got the perfect wall in the way. That's not good. That is not good. Ooh, no. Ooh, no. That's not good at all. No, it is not good at all. If I can live this next assault, I should be able to win. Okay. I believe I won. Yeah, I won. There we go. Just barely won out thanks to Louise's horrible health. Oh, and as you guys can see, I switched back to Bender because my Bender is now level 6, which means he now has more life than Tina. But once Tina reaches level 6, I will be permanently staying with her over Bender. Unless Bender has like 3 levels ahead of Tina, Tina is now my permanent character. Okay, we'll go with wrestling. Simply because it gets stronger and heals. Then we'll have Bob Jean to ensure that my guys can last long. Whoa. Hello, wrestling. I didn't expect to see you coming out so soon. I wasn't prepared to play. How tough is Susan Boyle again? Ooh, this is not good. Okay, I'm gonna go with Leela. Oh, wait, I could have made Blurn's Ball Leela. That might have actually been a smart move to do. You know what? Nah, maybe I can still salvage that. I mean, it's not too horrible, I suppose. So we can make Shamu. We can make Susan Boyle. Will do 3 damage per turn. Or we can make Drunk Leela, who has an 11 wall, which would be amazing, but they've reached a point where they can get past my ridiculously high wall stat. You have a pretty high wall too, though, so if I get something to mix with wrestling, you can do some damn good damage. So yeah, we'll go for you. I feel like that's the best option right now. You can't combine with wrestling, and you can't combine with wrestling. Damn it. Okay, we'll place Bill next. We'll place Bill Nye the Science Guy. Kill that immediately. Decrease your attack. Okay. Ooh, that Stan is dangerous. That Stan is damn dangerous. Okay. Sauced Bill. Not like it really mattered, because I won in the end. I really do need to learn to pay more attention. I keep missing out these minor details. There have been so many times where all I had to do to win them. Oh, wow, so Bender's dialogue still works. Well, yeah, I guess Tina just doesn't have dialogue. That's stupid. So, yeah, there have been so many times where I've lost matches because I didn't pay attention and actually noticed the fact that I could have won a certain match by killing them before they killed me. Hello, Bobby. God dang it, Bobby. That boy ain't right, tell you what. I tell you what. Did I ever tell you what? Because I told him what. Okay, and that's enough of that. Oh, God. Steve actually killed one of my cards. Steve killed his father. Okay. I guess I'll go with Tina for now. I'll go with Tina Fey for now. Eight attack, 12 defense, and double that, and 11. Not really much I can do about this other than just increase my damage output. Ooh, yeah, thank you. That was a lucky punch. But yeah, I would have survived anyway, so it's all good. Okay. Four more matches to go. Start off with that sexy, sexy Bildo tree. Get Stan the man out there. Costume Bill up, because fuck it. I've recently learned just how amazing Costumed Bill is with that ridiculous 8 bomb. Eight bomb and nine attack. Stan will die. Oh, right. It has to be the Peter Copter. Fuck. Alright, Bob Jean. Stan has to punch that specifically to survive. He did not punch the store specifically. You're not good at your job, Stan. Lucky for you, Bender's got your back. Because Bender is great. Oh, also, Bill is still broken. I forgot. You know, I randomly started watching some shows because of this game. I checked out Bob's Burgers out of pure curiosity, and I rewatched an episode of King of the Hill solely because, oh my god, I got Stan the Man. And I rewatched an episode of King of the Hill all because of a picture that was posted on their Facebook. I hope I don't end up leveling up. Oh fuck, I did. I'm gonna end the episode when I reach 10 of these because if I clear that out now, it's gonna be ridiculous. I'm probably not gonna use Stan. Let's just look at what he got. 37 health and punch level 2. Oh, so Stan will actually be on par with Bender health-wise. Oh wait, never mind. He won't be on par with Bender. He'll be near Bender, not on par with him. So yeah, I'll just play until I'm down to 9. I know I said 10, but I actually have this personal thing of I don't like letting points go to waste. I'm not points. I don't let like time go to waste, and that's exactly what I would be doing if I were to just leave with that, so. Well, that's not nice. You shouldn't be punching Alderman in the face. Okay, so now Bobby can't hurt me directly. It can hurt me indirectly, but not direct. Whoa, okay, I was wrong. He still did 1 damage to me. God dang it, Bobby. Ooh, this guy's really giving me a run for my money. Okay. It's all good, though. This turn will give me the advantage. Thank God. And thanks to the raw power that my first 2 cards pack, I should easily win this. Well, not easily. I wouldn't call it easy when some of my strongest cards are actually at the brink of death. But my HP has... Well, my HP has been touched, actually. I keep forgetting that I always give up HP at the start of a match to get my powerful cards out. And now I get a crisp, clean 800 Nixon coins for every match. That's just lovely. I remember keep hearing about how difficult it is in Arena once you reach Tier 15. So, I felt like there would be like a massive boost in difficulty here. Lucky for me, there clearly wasn't. They're still roughly the same difficulty. Which, believe me, is a good thing. Oh my god. It's such a good thing. Burger. Alright, next turn Vat Bender dies. And my Burger Suit can take 1 more hit, so instead of going for Burger Suit, I will go for School. Oh no. You weren't supposed to do that. Why would you do that? Okay. I'm gonna get out my own Clobberella. Get some revengeance. Okay. That was good. I think I survived? No, I don't. Amy... Wow, Amy had 12 attack. I didn't realize how ridiculously high Amy's attack got. Just how much of a boost did Clobberella give her? Because Amy's supposed to be a relatively low-power card. She's supposed to have 5 attacks, so that means Clobberella gave her 7? Why the hell did Clobberella give her 7? I need to level up my Clobberella, clearly. This is a horrible starting hand. I know I have no one to blame for myself, but myself for this hand, but God, I'm going to complain. You can call me salty all you want. I'm complaining. This is bullshit. This is so bullshit. Oh my God, this hand is horrid. And Clobberella's out to ruin my day. Lovely. Cause you had a bad day, you're taking 1 down, you sing a sad song just to turn it around, you tell me no, you tell me no, yeah, I'm fucked. I don't see how I'm going to win this. So, if you could just, like, stop, that would be swell. Yeah, I lost. I'm not even gonna try. I'm just gonna get Stan drunk because He's my favorite card, and as long as he's drunk, I'm happy. There are certain cards that when you have them, it's the greatest thing ever, but when your opponent has them, it becomes a fucking nightmare. Clobberella and Drunk Stan are those cards. It's never fun to be put up against them. I would say Bad Tina's also one of those cards, but she's so rare that it doesn't even bother me. But Clobberella was rare too, but then today she's just like, "Hey there, remember how you kept using me in battle? I think everybody you fought learned from you." I actually do wonder if I actually made Clobberella more popular, not through my YouTube channel, mind you, because nobody fucking watches my YouTube channel, but just through playing people in Arena. I wonder if somebody is like, "Holy shit, that Clobberella card is good, I need to add that to my deck. Need to add that to my dick. I'm trying to be funny and I'm failing." Ow. Uki. You. Block damage. Alright, I win this turn. Victory's my... Yay, yay, yay. You, stop making everything I say wrong. I don't appreciate that. Oh wait, no, I still won. Oh right, because of the costume party bonus. Alright. 9, and it's 11. I actually don't even know what time I started, so just looking at it, that doesn't do anything for me. I'm going to keep going until I reach 5,000 coins. At 5,000 coins, then I'm going to do the pack opening. So let's see if we can reach that 5,000 mark. Ooh. Because you had a bad day. I hate when that happens. The game's like, "Ooh, you have this kick-ass card that will make this match for you. Time to have literally everything targeted all of a sudden." Alright, I took a bit of damage to make it happen, but yeah, I won now. There's no coming back, I've won. Alright, let's get Peter here to block this fucker. Crush, crush. And I win next turn. Also, I find it interesting how they call S&M Peter a disguised card when an S&M outfit isn't really a disguise, per se. Why do I keep looking at the time? I know what time it is. Ooh, this is a pretty high-level Bob. I don't like this. You, stop being high-level right now. I need to combine things. I need to combine things. I don't have a choice in the matter. Things need to be combined. We'll make Bender in love so that he can keep himself alive, keep me defended a bit longer. Alright, we got the piano. I don't have to make a combination this turn, so I'm still going to put something in the block, and then next turn I'll make another combination. So we'll put wrestling, because I like me some wrestling. And then Leela will come out to play. Because Linda, I was about to say Linda barely does anything, but no, she literally does nothing. Leela is... not Leela. Linda is literally nothing. Linda is like the worst character in all of existence, which makes her nothing. She really is a horrible character, though. Fuck Linda. Just fuck her. Not in the good way, either. In the why do you exist way. In the why are you on the show way. Is this a win? I think that... Nah, I counted my chickens before they hatched. But it doesn't matter. I still win the match overall, even if I didn't win that turn specifically. SNM Peter is a beautiful card if you can live long enough to see his full effects. I literally combined for the sake of combining, and SNM Peter still gave me the win. $48,000. So three more wins, or two wins and a loss? No. Has to be three more wins. A loss and two wins won't get me it. Burger suit. When in doubt, burger suit. No, this is the first time I'm ever going to go right for the toga bill. But I'm going to do it because it will kill the alcohol next turn. Or it could make a drunk fry. You know what? I still kill the alcohol in two turns, so... We'll just get out... Bender. Because he'll take less damage. I ain't afraid of no Fry. And then Fry dies this turn, so I might as well just put SNM Peter here to block Hank. I normally don't play this smart. But then again, can you even call common sense being smart? Alright, so I have a healer out. I have SNM Peter wreaking havoc. Today's a good day. Today's a good day. Cause you had a good day. You had a good day. Okay, get Louise there. Dodgeball Louise has some fucking insane craze on her. Also, I don't remember if I found this on camera or not, but if your card already has crazed and is a sports card, the crazed will not double because of Roid Rage, so don't try thinking you can stack up on crazes and just become unbearably powerful. You can't. Roid Rage only works on those that don't already have the rage effect ability. Bleh. That sucks. Lila will lose her extra attack. Alright, I'm gonna put Stan. Stan the man. Then I'm going to put the burger suit. Burger suit, please live this. Okay. Now we bring out Clobberella. Who does not have as much attack as I wanted her to. Stan, you really should have punched Louise. Clobberella, no! Oh, I just lost this match. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. I just lost this match. Yep, lost. Surrender. Making this episode longer than it needs to be. Thanks, game. Then again, maybe there is someone out there actually thanking the game for that. Who knows? I just realized my bill isn't even completely leveled up yet, so for all I know, my bill's thing might become even more ridiculous in the future. And by thing, I mean it's bomb. Alright, send Bender out. to be all shield-like and kill Bob when he attacks me. Like the bitch Bob is. You're a bitch, Bob. You're a bitch. Get Stan drunk. Bring out the S&M goodness. I just realized how good Togepi is at nerfing as well. I should have realized before how amazing Togepi was. I don't think I used him much until recently. Okay, I believe I just need one more win, then I can start the pack opening. Yeah, one more win, and I can start the pack opening. Then again, I'm so low on arena matches at this point that I might as well just finish them off, shouldn't I? Holy shit, I should have paid attention. Hello, Bobby. God dang it, Bobby, don't you think your life's a little ridiculous, boy? Yeah, I'm gonna go for Hank instead. I just feel more comfortable with Hank, honestly. Please punch the bear bottles. Of course you don't. Why would you? Okay, that's not too bad. There goes Buildo Tree, but you know what? I'll live. Actually, no, I won't. Oh god, that stand might actually make damn sure of it that I don't. All I can do is try to out damage. Then I remember his health. I don't think I'm winning this. I was hoping their punches would find their way to that stand over there. Okay, I lost this match. That is a damn strong Bobby. Like, dear God, how many levels did that person have on that Bobby? I mean, yeah, I could have found out by clicking their name, but what fun's that? What fun is that? You. Because you get boosts for days. Then we'll get you out. Because Bender is the greatest, clearly. Take a little bit of a beating. And hope Bender's fist lands true. Good, Bender. Nice job. I'm not gonna say you guarantee me the victory, because that would be way too preemptive, but you gave me the advantage, at least. And advantage lost. God damn it, Bender, you suck. Get good at your job. And Louise is almost dead. Lovely. Lucky for me, I win this turn. I think this is the strongest my Luis has ever gotten. Also, I have no clue how Luis healed. She just did. Because reasons. And I only have two matches left, so I might as well just do them. Okay, Peter, come on. Be broken for me, friend. Ooh, that hurt. Oh god, not this fucking card again. This card is literally the worst thing ever. It's the worst thing ever. Worst thing ever. It's the worst thing ever. Worst thing ever. It's the worst thing ever. Worst thing. Okay, there we go. It's dead. It's dead, and I'm happy. Although, now, Peter's dead. God damn it, you killed Peter! You bastard! Wait, god damn it, no, it's... Oh my god, they killed Peter! You bastards! We don't take kindly to South Park fans in this part of town, you hear? Alright, last battle before the biggest pack opening I will ever hold in this game. And yes, I'm counting my chickens before I hatch. This is going to be the biggest pack opening I ever do. Because I know damn sure no one's going to be giving me money to buy packs. Okay. Teddy Ruxpin. Punch SNM Peter. Good. Because he can technically heal, so fuck you. Santa Bill, we all love Santa Bill. Punch Peter. Yes, you are an idiot. Dead. Punch Peter. Okay, that works too. I mean, it sucks, but... Eh. I mean, I win the match, so who cares, I guess. You actually might have been able to make me eat my words had you actually punched Santa Claus instead. Actually, no, because SNM Peter would have still killed, so never mind. Actually, no, maybe SNM Peter wouldn't have killed. Maybe that would have... Maybe it was Bill's motivation that put him over the edge. Who knows? Anyway... Let's go ahead and clear up my inventory a bit. Okay, now that we have my inventory as clear as it's going to be, we shop. Cards. And let us watch as even with 52 cards, I still somehow don't get a legendary. I should at the very least get an epic. If I don't get an epic, I'm just gonna quit this game outright. Oh right, and since it's an insane amount and card limits are a thing, I'm gonna get like no giggity watts whatsoever. Even though getting giggity watts after your cards is just beautiful. Giggity, toy, whatever that said, giggity, Kuchikopi, gamer, giggity, lottery winnings, whatever that says, money, lottery winnings, whatever that says, Kuchikopi, whatever that says, school, Bob's Burgers, school, Burger Boss, Quagmire, Fresher, Million Dollar Can, Burger Boss, Manager Babies. I actually really liked the Manger Babies episode. Oh, what do you know? I got a car I don't fucking like. This game is like, alright, Dwayne, fine, we'll give you an epic so you don't leave the game. Really, game? You're gonna give me something good? Sure, here's a card you don't like. But it's still technically part of my deck, and I can't... I wonder if it actually recorded the fact that my battery's low. And I guess I can combine, so that's something, I guess. Well, I didn't even reach max inventory. That sucks. For those of you guys wondering why I'm not feeding this away, it's because I don't know if I'm going to use it in the future or not. As you guys have seen, there are field effects that can make or break the tide of battle. And I'm pretty sure one of those field effects is going to have to do with educated cards. Which is why I'm not, and I'm pretty sure that Dispeter card makes educated combos. So I'm not exactly quick on the thought of getting rid of that Peter card just yet. Feed. Uki. Combine. Fusion, huh? Badoop. 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 And I know I'm gonna get a ridiculous amount of rare cards soon, so I will be able to make up for that, like, real quick. And I'll be able to combine my spaceships as a result of it, so... Let's go to challenges. Rewards. I'm not getting Bobby. We're going to be buying a bunch of football chance packs. Let's see if I can get something good. Probably not. I know this game too well. Okay, I got Leela. I'm not going to call that good. Okay, game. You have my attention. Okay, I used up all my luck immediately. Lovely. Lovely jubblies. Not a waste of rest on commons. Well... I want to complain. I want to complain, but they gave me two epics and two legends and yeah, epics in a row, so I guess I can't. I mean, I still want to. I'm still not happy. I still want a legendary, but I mean, let's be real. Getting legendaries is the only reason you do the boxes. It is the only reason. Huh. I have a lot of energies there. Did I feed something I wasn't supposed to? I don't think I did. Oh well. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys the next thing something of noteworthiness happens. Deuces, YouTube.